عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه جل جلاله وعم نواله، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وأصحابه نجوم الهدى قادة التقى. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد: والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما. صدق الله العظيم. My respected elders, brothers, mothers, and sisters, moving on with the discussion that we had started about a month ago, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the qualities of His beloved servants. So number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. Allama Razi rahimahullah in his tafsir mentions a very beautiful point. He says the two points, the two qualities that were mentioned before this one, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا, and those who spend their nights for their Allah, for their Lord, in sajda and in standing, in prostration and in qiyam, in standing. This is the loose translation of this ayah. The two qualities that were mentioned before, الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Those who tread, those who walk upon the earth with calm, with ease, with humbleness, and those who, when they are addressed by those who are ignorant, they remain patient, they say assalamu alaikum, or they say that which is appropriate. Allama Razi rahimahullah mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by mentioning the first two qualities, describe the day of a believer, how the day of a believer should be. And he says that the first quality indicates, hints towards the fact that a believer should be such that nobody, nay, any creature should not be harmed by a believer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he takes this meaning from this ayah of the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they are humble in their approach, hence they don't harm others, rather they are those who overlook, they are those who always give the benefit of the doubt, they are those who always have good thoughts, assumptions regarding others. So they don't harm others. And number two, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When they are addressed, and sometimes they may be insulted, sometimes they may be physically assaulted, verbally assaulted, whatever it may be, they are such, they say قَالُوا سَلَامًا, they are able to tolerate the pain of others. They are able to tolerate the pain that others inflict upon them. So number one, not only do they not harm others, but when others harm them, they are patient over that as well. This in short, Allama Razi rahimahullah says, this in short summarizes how the day of a believer should be. Moving forward, he says, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ رَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. The quality which we have been discussing today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who spend their nights for their Lord in sujood and in qiyam, in prostration and standing, in prayer. Allama Razi rahimahullah says, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning the night of a believer, how the night should be. As I was mentioning last week and the weeks prior to that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept the perfect example in Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for us. The perfect example, there is no doubt in that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stamped that, has certified that. It is very regretfully stated that those who believe in the same Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, unfortunately, I speak to myself first, are the ones who are far away from the method of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his tariqah, his lifestyle. So Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhuma was a cousin of Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam, a young boy. In his young age, in his youth, he says, he relates this incident later on. He says, I spent the night at the house of my aunt Maymuna radiyallahu anha, who was one of the wives of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So he got this opportunity, although he was a nephew of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, but for them to spend the night in someone's house in this particular manner, where he wanted to observe the night of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, it would not have been appropriate or suitable for him to do so. However, he got the opportunity because his wife, one of the wives of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, Maymuna radiyallahu anha, was also his aunt. So he says, I got this opportunity. On one hand is my uncle, my cousin, and on the other hand is my aunt. So it's a home for me. So I took this opportunity because I spent the night with Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in his room. What is the purpose of spending the night? Solely to see. The purpose is just to observe, see what Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam does throughout the night. Allahu Akbar. His day is documented, is visible, is apparent to anyone and everyone. He socializes, he goes out, he talks, he deals. He goes to the masjid, he leads salah, he makes wudu, people see. He performs salah, people see. But what about his night? What about his night? So Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu said, I took this upon myself that I wanted to observe. I wanted to pass on and share this bit of knowledge with the ummah. So he said, I spent the night with Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And what I observed, what I saw, was Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam returned home from Isha Salah. He spent some time with his wives. He had some conversation with them. Again, a very beautiful point. A very, very beautiful point. My brothers and sisters, when you and I return from work, when we're tired, we're exhausted, the whole day has expired, and we return home and we go back to our families and our kids, what is the first thing we should be doing with them? What is the first thing we should be doing with them? Not putting the kids to sleep. Not saying that, oh, I'm exhausted, you know, I've just spent the whole day. You guys go to sleep, I need my free time now. I need my free space. Allahu Akbar. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, having the utmost greatest responsibility any mankind has ever had. Just imagine the stress. Just imagine the burden that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam must have felt. The greatest responsibility. Yet, Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhumah says, when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam returned from the Isha prayer, the salah, the very first thing he did was spend some time conversing and having a conversation, talking, chit-chatting with his spouse. Thereafter, after this discussion was over, he made wudu and he went to sleep. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam slept. He woke up. He realized that it was time for his salah. He is rubbing his face to get rid of the sleep. يَمْسَحُ وَجْهَ. As you and I would do when you wake up, you rub your eyes, you rub your face just to get yourself awake. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is doing the very same thing. He looks up to the sky and he recites some ayat of the Quran. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Some narrations mention that he read from there till the end, 10 ayat of the surah. Thereafter he got up, he made wudu. After having performed wudu, he started performing salah. He performed rak'at of salah. The narrations differ, 8, 11, 12, 13. He performed his tahajjud prayer. He performed his salah. Thereafter, he went back to sleep for a bit, to the extent that Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhuma says, I heard him snoring. We were able to tell that Nabi alayhi salatu was, he was sleeping because we heard him snoring. Thereafter, Bilal radiallahu anhu called out the adhan. He got up and then he went to the masjid. My brothers and sisters, the point of discussion here, Allama, the ayah hasn't even been discussed yet. We're still getting to the top of the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, despite having the most busy schedule any individual has ever had in the history of mankind, is able to spend a portion of his night in salah. This portion, don't you and I assume, don't assume, when we say that he got up, he performed this sets of rakat, and then he went back to sleep. Don't assume this was a 5-minute job. Don't assume this was a 10-15 minute job. Aisha radiallahu anha says, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam would stand in prayer in the night for so long, that his feet would get swollen due to standing. I said to him, O Messenger of Allah, why this when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven you? Whatever has passed, whatever may possibly happen in the future, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven you. Why this? And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam responded and replied, I wish that I may be from amongst those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shall I not be a grateful servant of Allah then? If these are the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me with, then shall I not be from amongst those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Inshallah, in the coming weeks, we will discuss a little bit more about this ayah. There are two meanings to this ayah. يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. And we'll elaborate inshallah a little more. Number one could be the sunan and the nawafil that a person performs between Maghrib and Isha Salah, or those after Isha Salah. To note, to understand, inshallah, we will discuss a little more. Number two is the Tahajjud Salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who are punctual in both, in performing the Salah al-Jama'at, Maghrib, Isha, performing the extra Nawafil, and make us amongst those who spend a portion of the night standing and prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alladhi bitahmidihi yustaftahu kullu bab, wa bidhikrihi yustaru kullu khitab, wa natubu ilayhi tawbata man yuqinu annahu rabbul arbab wa musabbibul asbab. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه صلاة تنقذنا من هول يوم العرض والحساب وتمهدنا عند الله زلفى وحسن مآب. أما بعد، فإن التوبة عن الذنوب بالرجوع إلى ستار العيوب وعلام الغيوب مبدأ طريق السالكين ورأس مال الفائزين وأول إقدام المريدين ومفتاح استقامة المائلين ومطلع الاصطفاء والاجتباء للمقربين. وقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى: والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن العبد إذا اقترف ثم تاب تاب الله عليه. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: إن الله يقبل توبة العبد ما لم يغرغر. وقال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الندم توبة. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. وقال: من كانت له مظلمة لأخيه من عرضه أو شيء فليتحلله منه اليوم قبل أن لا يكون دينار ولا درهم. إن كان له عمل صالح أخذ منه بقدر مظلمته، وإن لم يكن له حسنات أخذ من سيئات صاحبه فحمل عليه. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فمن تاب من بعد ظلمه وأصلح فإن الله يتوب عليه، إن الله غفور رحيم. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه، إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، المبعوث إلى الأسود والأحمر، المنعوت بشرح الصدر ورفع الذكر، وصلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين هم خلاصة العرب العرباء وخير الخلائق بعد الأنبياء. أما بعد، فيا أيها الناس، أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله والمواظبة على ذكر الله، ألا خير الكلام كلام الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صلى علي صلاة صلى الله عليه بها عشرا. واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم، فبدأ بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون، فقال تبارك وتعالى مخبرا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، خصوصا على الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعلى سائر الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر من نصر الإسلام والمسلمين واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل الإسلام والمسلمين ولا تجعلنا منهم ولا معهم. عباد الله، رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله تعالى يذكركم، وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وحسنك وشكرك. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام. اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد. اللهم إنا نسألك من كل خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من كل شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. صلى الله تبارك وتعالى خير خلقه سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك الرحمن.